no matter what you're going through. I know that you can stand.
Greetings to you, beloved, in Christ Jesus. May goodness and mercies always abound for you, and may grace continue to increase in every facet of your life. I am so glad to come your way again with a word that I believe and know will illumine and bless you a lot. Thank you for sharing, for liking, for viewing, and for commenting on the previous message entitled Check Your Surroundings. Today's message is entitled Check the Provision. Yes, check the provision. I believe that life is a question we must answer. You see, the problem is not really a problem, it is a question. The issue is not really an issue, it is a question. And we must do all to answer this question. You see, some have given up, some have decided not to answer the questions at all, thereby settling for less. But there are some of us that have chosen to answer to the question that life throws at us. And in our quest to answer, we must always check the provision. So I go to the Word of God and I'm trying to find what sealed this message a lot. And I'm taking to Acts chapter 4, verse 29. It is there that I find the solution to the issues and to the questions of life. In Acts chapter 3, Peter ministered to a layman that received his instant healing, and Peter seized the opportunity to preach to the multitude that were amazed. And lo and behold, multitudes are added unto the church, and the Bible said that the number of the church increased to 5,000. You see, it is here that Peter is arrested with the others and put in prison. He's arrested for preaching. And I am so surprised that when Peter was on the sea, fishing in the sea, he had no issue. In fact, people applauded him. They were clapping for him. But the moment Peter switches from fishing on the sea to fishing among men, he has issues. It tells you and I that anytime you move from the wrong assignment to the right assignment, you have issues. And so the mere fact that you are going through problems and tribulations and issues does not mean that God is against you. It doesn't mean that you are in a sort of curse. It can only mean that you are on the right path. You are on the right path. And so I go to the Word of God, and I see Peter has an issue. He has been put in prison. And some way, somehow, they are released. And when they join the other disciples, they begin to pray a certain kind of prayer. You see, this is how they pray. They highlighted and checked the provision. They forewent the problem. Problems will always be there. But anytime there are problems, do well to check the provision. Let me tell you this. Issues will always be there. But don't make issues the issue of your life. Let me take it again. There will always be issues, but don't make issues the issue of your life. And so Peter rejoins the other disciples, the other apostles, and they begin to pray. The whole crowd of the disciples begin to pray. And in Acts chapter 4, verse 29, the whole climax of their prayer is there. This is how they pray. And now, Lord, observe their threats and grant to your bond servant full freedom to declare your message fearlessly. You see, initially they had received threatenings not to preach in the name of Christ again. They come back to pray and they are saying that, God, grant unto us boldness to preach that very same word again. It tells you that the prison and the threatening was not really the issue. It was not the problem. The problem was the provision. They had to check the provision. They had to counter on the provision. They had to highlight the provision, forgetting the problem. Problems will always be there. See, you can pray, you can fast, you can do all you will do, but a real freedom and a real power comes by checking the provision and not the problem. You see, so this is the climax of their whole prayer. Lord, the threat is there. The prison is there. We are not so concerned about this prison. We are concerned about a boldness and a fearlessness that is able to make us soar over the problem. What were they doing? They were checking the provision and not the problem. And you see, that is what you have to do. Problems will always be there. Issues will always be there. But you counter or you highlight on the provision to make you soar over the problem. So the encumbrance will be there. The obstacle will be there. But there is a provision, I bet you, when you take time to make a research of your own self, there are tenacities and abilities in you that will make you soar over the issue you are dealing with right now. If you take time to check within you, God has incubated into you things, powers, tenacity, abilities that will help you overcome the problem, because you were not born empty, though you were born naked. There are things and abilities in you that will help you soar over the problem. And that is the climax of their whole prayer. They were saying that, Lord, we don't care about the problem. We are not so concerned about the prison. We are concerned about the boldness. So let me tell you something. Whatever threatenings and prisons that are in your life right now, there are equal and higher provision. There are equal and higher boldness and fearlessness that you must use. Don't focus on the problem. Focus on the provision. And you see, in focusing on the provision, as I end it all, I want you to know that it is only when you problematize the problem that it becomes a problem. In actual sense, you are supposed to become a problem for that problem so that it leaves you. What am I saying? The demons at Gadara thought that they were the bosses of the day. They were ruling. They thought that they were the problem of the day. Until Jesus Christ set in. When Jesus Christ set in, Jesus Christ didn't problematize them. Jesus Christ didn't highlight them. Jesus Christ looked to the provision within him. He looked to the provision from above. And he was able to make the demons see that he, the Christ, was a greater problem for them. And so they have to leave the scene. That is what you should do. Anytime you check and highlight on the provision, you tell the problem that you are too little, you have to leave. There is a greater problem for you. That is what you have to do. Don't problematize the problem. Highlight on the provision. Check on the provision. Because as a matter of fact, life gives its best to those who make smiles out of lives. Life gives its best to those who rise up from crying. I don't know the problem you are going through now. I don't know the issues you are encountering now. But I bet you that when you take time to check on the provision, when you slow things down and you look at things well, you will realize that there is a provision. In climaxing it all, I want to say to you that if there was ever a time that you needed to check the provision, the time is now. And if there was ever a man to lead you to check the provision, that man is Jesus. Years ago, this man was asked, are you not the carpenter's son? He looked to them and said, no, I am not the carpenter's son. I was born by a carpenter, but I am the son of God. I don't know what society throws at you. I don't know what life throws at you. It may be a drill paper. It may be a failed examination. It may be an application for employment that went bad. It may be marital issues. But I tell you that there is a man called Jesus that can help you check the provision, that can help you minimize the problem and help you highlight your potential. That man is Jesus. And I want you to invite him into your life wherever you are. Just say that, Jesus, I want you to help me answer these problems. I want you to help me check and counter on the provision and not the problem. And I bet you, life will never remain the same. Always remember that life gives its best to those who fight back. The Bible says that weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. It only stands to reason that when you weep in the night, you have to get ready, wipe your tears, and stand up, brace up yourself, and be ready for the joy that is coming in the morning. Beloved, you've cried for a while, you've given up for a while, but I challenge you by this message, I challenge you by this video to rise up and fight back. Rise up, check the provision God has given you. There is always a provision to that problem. Don't let the problem diminish you. Don't let the problem eat you up. Rise up and say, Lord, look upon their threatenings and give us the boldness to preach the word of God. Check the provision and not the problem. God bless you. I got a witness in here somewhere. I know. Hallelujah. No matter what may come my way. No matter what may come.